us begin this session today. Ratios are very important over here. Okay. Every time you will see that if any client is reaching to you, whatever he is telling that he needs to invest the money. Suppose you will tell him any mutual fund, ABZ mutual fund, okay? ABZ mutual fund. He will definitely ask what is the performance for that mutual fund. In normal way, if you will see, we used to tell them that, sir, we have the 5 to 10 years of performance that we can show you. Performance has to be published by the, you know, by each mutual funds or by any banks also. Suppose if you will tell that I also have some banks in which you can open your FD. Now there are certain small banks also, small cap finance banks are also there actually. Some of the banks are there which is not approved by RBI also. Still people are going there and putting their money over there. There also they will ask from you what is the history of this bank. So performance and this history actually will be asked by any of your client. And as a part of this mandate, if any mutual fund is coming under the SEBI guidelines, they have to share their performance reports. Because every kind of investment, if you will see over here, it is having two components, risk and return. Whenever we have to calculate risk and return, we will be thinking from one unit of risk that we are taking. Okay, this will be our base. Suppose if we are taking one unit or 1 rupee of risk, how much return we can make? Okay. There are certain ratios that we can calculate. One of the ratio is Sharpe ratio, which I have in last class also we have discussed something about that. Hedge funds actually, and it is not only about the hedge funds. Now though, we have different type of investment classes over there. Like which I told you in my last class also. See, this is the mutual funds. I am talking about the traditional mutual funds. Okay. Traditional mutual fund, which is coming under the SEBI. They also have risk and they are also giving some returns. As I have told to you, risk, we will see from 1 rupees point of view. That if we are taking 1 rupee of risk, how much return we are generating. So what it means actually, if I will take this example of Sharpe ratio, it means higher is the ratio, it is better actually, because our base is same, 1 unit or 1 rupee of risk. It means if it is 0.50 Sharpe ratio, it means 50-50 percentage was our risk actually. If other mutual fund is there, B mutual fund, Sharpe ratio was good, 0.80. It means if I will compare mutual fund A from mutual fund B, I can tell from this ratio that mutual fund B has performed better. Because see, risk was same, but in mutual fund B, my Sharpe ratio was good. It means my return was good. So this is one of the way of seeing. It is not only about the mutual funds actually that I have talked about the, but also about the alternative investment funds. Alternative investment funds. There are what? Hedge funds. You have learned. And there is what? Private equity fund. Whatever fund you will take, it will be having some risk and some return. Whatever is there actually, that we have to calculate from Sharpe ratio. There are certain components that needs to be known before we will calculate that. One by one we'll see, okay, which are the components is required. Okay, and this is our risk and return framework. See here, suppose if you are telling to invest in any kind of equity, as I have told to you, there are different kind of equities are there to trade. Different kind of equities. Every equity will be having its beta actually. Every equity you will see beta will be there. Beta, why it is there actually? Because see, stock prices, if you will see, it is not like this. It will be like this. See, this is what actually, if you will see, this is what. These are the waves which is created by this log. Okay, or we can tell volatility. How we can measure it? Via beta. In normal sense, if you will see beta is greater than 1, then we can tell actually that is V is more, volatility is more. It means what actually? It means it can generate more returns. In the same way, it is also having a high risk. Because see, if returns is more, then risk will be more. Now, there are certain large cap companies. If you will see, most of the companies are financially very sound, very very sound. If you will see, beta is there less than 1, it means what? Volatility is less, it means they can give less or moderate return. In the same way, risk is also less. Thinking other factors remain same, we don't know what other things can come which can increase this V factor or waves, but thinking the ratio of beta, okay, let us see actually the beta of few companies out here. Okay, I will just close, try to finish assignments, so we will just go to the link now. In the same way, let me log in into my portal. Okay. So where you have to go, quick links, HICM, check me, ebooks, quick links, and then we'll go to here. Okay. There we'll go to volatility beta column. Let us check the beta of few of the companies which is large cap. Okay, first I should know what are the top companies, so I am going to top market capitalization. One by one we'll go and we'll see. Reliance, I hope you are aware of this portal, I have told you previously also. Reliance Industry. And then the volatility factor. I need a long term beta, okay? 1.2. Beta have increased little bit because of the market fluctuation. But still it is manageable, not much. See, it doesn't mean actually, because some of the financial students are having some doubts here actually. It doesn't mean that if beta is greater than 1, then it is not a good company to invest. See, Bajaj Finserv, if you will see, I will show you. Beta is more actually, but it is a good company. Huh? So it doesn't mean that. ACS. Again, we will go over here. Volatility. See, 0.447 actually. Second topmost company, very less beta. See, beta can reduce also. Okay, beta can reduce also. As I can give you this basic example, it will happen a multiple of times actually. that sometimes, see, there are zones. There are zones. Might be stock was up too much, so it was in overvalued zone. Overvalued zone. And prices have started falling. Now it has came in undervalued zone or consolidation zone. Okay. This is what? Consolidation zone. Or we can also tell the undervalued zone. Now, it doesn't mean that if stock prices have fallen, suddenly the buyers will come. Sometimes the market scenarios are not good. If you will see the current market scenario, American market is not performing well. And FI is also withdrawing their money actually. Okay. So, in this zone, it will move for much point of time. It will make very small waves. Okay. And if you will see from past 6-7 months, the beta of TCS has been reduced. Why? Because it is making very less waves. It is neither going down also because it is already fallen. And why it is not going up? Because market situation is not good actually. Okay, so beta has been reduced. I still know it was beta was more, huh? Base was more. Okay. I will take with the STFC. Volatility 1.11 is also not bad. Infosys. Okay. 1.11 is also fine. No, see, 0.60. Most of the large cap companies, beta you will find is on very less. It is fine. Infosys, ICICI Bank. See what? Why we have to do this exercise? There are multiple mindset that you will be meeting now in this market. Some people will tell, ma'am, I want to invest in equity market, but I want less risk. I know risk is there, but I want less risk. So if suppose you are lacking one company, suppose you have a personal bias towards SBI Bank. Suppose because you are thinking, oh, less risk, SBI Bank. Okay, it is a government bank. But we cannot guess here. Whatever is we have a data, we will check. Personal bias are not allowed here, to be very, very frank. That if I am liking, I will suggest. No. It will not work in this way. So you have to calculate and you should have a data. I see. Actual beta will be very less. We'll see. See, 0.140 return is also in this way only, in this stock. Okay, it will like big elephant only, like elephant will not move. This stock will, sometimes it will move and then it will sleep. For one year also it can sleep, you don't know. Such kind of stock it is actually. But you are seeing beta, 0.14, it is not moving only. See, if you will see this stock HUL, Chinese governments, when they will purchase some bonds like security, you check some Chinese mutual funds. They are coming in India and they are also purchasing stock like HUL because they are thinking it is safe. Neither it will move too much and neither it will go down too much. So it is fine if it is giving them 6-7% of return also in a year. They are very happy. Okay, but they want safety actually. Okay, where I was? SBI. SBI was okay. Volatility. See, V factor, which I am seeing beta, right? this we can calculate from CAPM model. See here, if you will see, beta is more actually. Okay, and it will happen. Sometimes it will fall so badly. Why it is falling so badly? Because it has exposure to more loans. Whenever you will see, just see the data actually. Whenever you will hear that this corporate house have done some big fraud, he has taken a loan and then they ran. Like we have Vijay Mallya, great Vijay Mallya. You will see SBI Bank will be having, you know, they would have been given loan to the debt corporate house. Most of the times you will see HDFC Bank will be there, ICICI Bank, and then because they are, you know, they will form a loan cartel actually, and then combinedly they will give a small portion of loan so that, you know, they can divide their risk. Okay, SBI Bank, then we have, okay, we'll see. For 5-10 stocks, we'll see, then we will have HDFC. Okay. See, HDFC is different and HDFC housing finance. Okay, housing finance, because most of the people see this is HDFC. Volatility 1.09. Okay, two more we'll do. See, these kind of exercise you also do, okay? And then LIC India. LIC is also one of the very big companies. See, in top 10 companies, LIC name is coming. It was top 3, but now the market valuation has reduced actually a little bit. Life insurance finance. Because see, it will give us the beta for 1 year. And
1 year is not yet.
1 year have not completed. Okay, it is fine actually. Okay, we can take Adani Enterprises. Volatility. 1.56. So what you have understood now, large cap companies, if you will see, okay, most of under the beta of 1 only, okay. See, we have a threshold limit till 1.5. If you will see, this is little bit more beta is there for SBI Bank, and same to same is for Adani. Okay, restless. Less is then 1 actually. It means risk and return can be managed in top 10 companies actually. Okay, without any personal bias actually. When if you have some more company which is having less than 1 beta, sometimes, see, there are different reasons actually. Okay, now there are certain reasons that needs to be understood from this. See, reason 1 is what actually? That stock is highly liquid stock. It means what? Liquidity is very high. Buyers and sellers are there and they are buying and selling. See, what is this actually? Buying and selling on different prices actually. Suppose there is a stair. Okay. Stair, when you will climb, it is having some stairs actually. When if you want to climb your terrace, there will be stairs. Okay, some stairs are without any gap. It means you will not fall, because step by step you will go high. Huh? In some of the hotels, you will see that if you want to go to a terrace, stairs will be having a large gaps. So there you will afraid when you will go up or when you will come down. See, these gaps are what actually in stairs actually. It can, you know, it is not good actually. If somewhat your focus will be here and there, you can fall down because there are too much of gaps. In the same way, when this stock place is a order driven market actually, where buyers and sellers are there. See here, buyers will bid actually here on different type of prices actually. If buyers and sellers are there on each prices, bid and ask spread difference will be very very less actually. In this case, on every prices of 10 paisa or 20 paisa, buyers and sellers are there to support, which is not letting the price to fall. Okay, in this wave only it will make small waves. This is the reason why you are seeing that why in large cap companies beta is very very less, because buyers and sellers are there to support the price on each and every level. If any selling is coming on any particular price, buyers are also there to support. But in this case, what is happening? Adani Enterprise. Okay, buyers and sellers are there, but not on every price actually. They are there having the big stairs. It means if prices will start falling, there are no, you know, buyers to support. Or if the prices are start rising, there are no sellers to sell. Okay, so it will make very big ways. Understood, right?
Yeah.
See, you can also check. I can give you, because see, theoretical has to be justified with the practical. If you will open the market window, see now. In the first row, if you will check now, prices are live. Okay, market is live. 2540, it will change.
Yeah.
And 254. See, buyers and sellers 30 paisa. Buyers and sellers are there to support the prices. Huh? Let me do this exercise with Adani also. Adani Enterprise. Differences. We will check. Okay. See here, prices having a difference of 22 rupees over here. 82.70 and 80.50. You are seeing, right?
Mm.
Okay, and if you will see this window, and if you will compare from this window, okay, you will find the volumes are very active over here actually. Volumes are also very active.
What is bid and ask? What is the difference?
Okay, see what we mean by bid and ask. Let me give you a layman example. Okay. Let me take the example of tomato. Tomato, if you want to purchase a tomato, mm-hmm. suppose, whom you will go? The you will go to a seller, mm-hmm. person who is selling a tomato, right? See, this is a seller actually. Okay. Seller will ask the price. What is his price? Mm-hmm. Now, if there are 10 sellers, 10 sellers are selling tomato. Which seller you will prefer to buy? Person who is paying you the less price.
Yeah.
Huh? So in this way, if you will see this window is arranged. The best seller, best price is on the first row. Best price you will see in the first row. It will segregate by itself. You don't need to find that who is giving me the best price. Let me go and click on that. Sheet only and I will buy from him only. No. Whatever the price you are seeing on the trading will happen as per the market price. This is the best seller only. Okay. And suppose for an example that if you have a tomato which you want to sell, now where you will go? You will go to the buyer. See, buyer will bid. Okay. Buyer will bid. Huh? Now, if it is a bidding system and you have to sell your tomato, which buyer you will prefer? Who will pay you the highest price? So this window is arranged like that only. the person who can give you the best price will come on the first screen. You understood, right?
Yeah.
Got it.
And what is that quantity related? Like, for that amount, this much quantity you have to pay or
no? Yes. So, this what you are seeing actually, okay? Suppose actually, same example I will give you and you will understand. Huh? Suppose, if you want to sell a tomato, okay? Now, there are different buyers are there. 10 buyers are there. Suppose, the person who is giving you the price on 100 rupees per kg of tomato, okay? Who can give you on, he has a demand that, ma'am, I need only 10 kg of tomato. 10 kg. Okay. Okay. This is in terms of the quantity. And that person can give you on 100 rupees per kg. But you have 100 kg of tomato. Suppose. So, first of all, you will go to him and you will try to sell him 10 kg. Rest you left with what? 90 kg. Now you will go to second buyer. Second buyer can tell you, if you are placing a market driven market price order over here, that, you know, I can pay you on 95 rupees per kg. Huh. But my demand is that I can purchase 20 kg from you. Again, you will let with 70 kg, then you will go to third. Understood, right? So, what it means actually? This is their consumption, what they want. It means at a price of 3780, there are 7 quantity requirement from this particular person. And this
okay,
window
if I
will...
click that, I have to get those 35 quantities compulsorily, right?
Yeah, but you should sell.
Yeah.
Then only they will consume. Okay. And see, there is no need for you to click on this line. If you want to click, you only have to go here, sell.
Yeah.
Okay, or you have to click on buy.
No, I'm just asking.
Huh, yes. Huh?
The quantities, they set the quantities.
Huh, quantity. Suppose actually, see, if this one buyer is there, if he needs 91 quantity or 88 quantity. Now, if you...
Huh,
wait, I'm coming. Suppose if you have only 10 quantity to sell, if you want to sell only 10 quantity, but he wants to purchase 100 quantity, okay, then also transaction will happen over here. Whatever you want to sell, they will consume. Okay, whatever you want to sell, they will consume. You are not the only person who is selling. Other person will come, he will be having more quantity. But whatever is your quantity, it will be consumed here. Okay, they will not tell that this person wants to consume 63 quantity. If you will sell 63 only, then you can sell. Whatever one also you want to sell, you can sell. People are here to consume, huh?
Okay.
See, this is the process of NSC exchange to help buyers and sellers to meet here and do trading. Huh? But in case of future options, yes, there are certain kind of lot size in which compulsory you have to buy. Suppose if you will click on this call option, 250 lot needs to buy, sell. Okay, that is important. Okay. So, let me go to my second chapter. In which, okay, we will see risk and return. Okay, this is one thing. Performance is seen by the sharpen ratio. This we will see actually. Risk adjusted returns. See, understanding of risk and return is very, very important. And I am telling to you, if on the basis of this model, risk and return, okay, you can make some complex models for your clients. Okay, it means complex for you to make, because when you will make, you have to focus and you have to put the data, but it will be easy for them to take the decision. Okay, risk and return, we will see. rather this theory, I will take you to the Chapman ratio. Client will be having one question actually, and it is the most common question that any client can ask from you. Ma'am, which is the mutual fund which I should invest? Okay. And then you will tell, okay, you have the A, B, C, D, because you will also give some options. Okay, you have this 10, 5 or 8 mutual fund. Then he will ask, ma'am, out of this 8 or 10 mutual fund, which you are telling, which is the best one? Which one you will suggest actually? See, might be the thing is there that you are an agent of this A mutual fund and you have a bias. See, bias can be of various types actually. I am telling to you, some bias are personal bias. Might be personally, you have invested your money in this mutual fund and this mutual fund is giving good return. Okay, from past, you know, 1 year. So you will tell, no, invest in this. See, people, when they will tell, they are only seeing a return. But as a professional financial advisor or counselor, we should also see a risk that is getting involved into that. Risk and return. I am telling to you, 99% people who are advising other people that you invest in this mutual fund, they will only see a return. They will not see a risk. But as a professionally, we have to see a risk also. That we will see now, step by step, personal bias. Second thing is that I am telling to you, please don't mind. I am just saying on a general way, okay? Profit sharing. Might be this A mutual fund is giving us more profit. So we are thinking, oh, B is good. Okay, after we'll see risk and return. Oh, no, we will go for A only because we are getting. This is also a kind of bias which is moving around here and there actually, okay. So this is one of the things actually. Okay, other things are also there. What is there? Because see, person who is managing the fund manager, it is also very important. Who are the fund managers actually? It is very, very important for you to see from the fundamental point of view before you are checking any ratios, their complete profile. Nowadays, everything is available on internet actually. Okay, and their historical data actually. Historical data, what was their past performance actually. Whenever we have to see their past performance, we should see on the worst situations. See, when the market is good, even the fool can perform good. I am telling to you, even a fool mutual fund can do good in a good market. Because if he is purchasing bogus shares also, it will generate a good return. We have saw there is a herd mentality actually here. When the market is good, na, bogus and condemned shares will also increase actually here. And they will also give excellent returns and save having purchased by this mutual fund actually. But we have to see in the worst situation, okay, worst situations, how this mutual fund has performed. See, risk and return, which I have told to you, is calculated by Sharpe ratio. How is the return of this mutual fund? But before we will calculate the Sharpe ratio, we should have certain components and inputs to know. Okay. See, first is the return. What return has been generated by this mutual fund? Okay. If you will see, I have divided by 100 because I am seeing 12% of return. So 12 divided by 100, it will come 0.12. I will tell you how I am calculating. This is the A mutual fund and this is the B mutual fund. Now, this is 12% of return. See, if I will hide these components over here, I will tell from his return only that B mutual fund has not performed good. And according to me, a mutual fund has performed good. Suppose if I don't have any personal bias, if I am genuine financial advisor, whichever is good, I will tell. So I will tell, boss, you go for a mutual fund because his return is good.
But this is not a complete study. See, my complete study will come when I will know the standard deviation and risk-free rate of return. See, risk-free rate of return, we cannot ignore. If you will see the CAPM model also that we are preparing. Because we have to understand from logical point of view now actually. Okay, if I am... Okay, it is fucking fine. Okay. If I am calculating the return on equity, person is having 10,000 rupees. Every person in this world will be having alternatives. See, I am not talking about investment alternatives. Are bhai, we have alternative when we are drinking tea or we have to drink coffee. We have alternative. Alternatives are there at any of our decision in personal life also. So here though we have definitely. If I have 10,000 rupees, either I can go in equity or either I can go in fixed deposits, which is risk-free return, or either I can purchase government bonds, which is the purely risk-free return, my safe investment. So how come when I am calculating any kind of ratio, I will not take this thing in considered alternatives, I cannot. So sharp ratio, because if person is coming to us and he's telling, ma'am, I want to invest in mutual funds. At that point of time, he would have been thought of risk-free return. Okay, which I am taking on 3%, not more. Let's just keep on. Suppose he is keeping idle money in saving bank account. Not doing an FD also. It will give 2.53% of return. So 3.3 divided by 100 also I have 0.03. And then what is mean by standard deviation actually? It means what? Shows the volatility of an investment return relative to its average return. What is the volatility of that mutual fund? See, if you will see mutual funds, every mutual fund is having a NAV. Okay. Net asset value. Every mutual fund is having a NAV, that is called a net asset value. See, this NAV will go up and down. It means it will make waves. See, mutual fund are known for what? Mutual fund are known for stability, security, safety, right? Risk is same. Because more or less, if I will take an example of equity mutual fund, their NAV is dependent on bond securities. If NAV will not perform good, mutual fund obviously have to fall. Huh? But actually, it also depends on the return actually. Okay, risk and return. So, this I will check with the volatility factor actually, how they have managed this volatility actually. If mutual fund is telling that I am an index-based mutual fund, okay, if mutual fund will tell, I am an index-based mutual fund. If index is fallen, suppose for an example, this I will give you an example of. See, today market has fallen by 0.50%. Half percentage down, right? Now, same to same, there is one ETF. I am sure that you are aware, Nifty B's ETF. Nifty B's ETF, if you will see, it has also fallen by 0.22%. Okay, rather it has fallen less only. Okay, but if it has fallen by 2% today, then what you have assumed over here, as you will see, that they are not replicating index. Suppose if you will see the bank B's over here. Bank B's, okay. Let me give you one more example. This is the bank B's, fallen by 0.30% down. Okay. Futures also, if you will see, 0.50% down. Somewhat here and there difference will be there, but I think it is fallen less. See, there is also a point to know. Sometimes on one particular day, market is down by only 0.5% and ticker has fallen by more, 0.70%.
next day it will average out. Then you will see that today it is falling less actually, because last day it was fallen more. So it will average out at the end of a month. Okay. So this is what you should know. So this is what standard deviation will tell us. It means, what should I know of any mutual fund? Standard deviation. See, there are certain portals which I'll tell you, which will give you this data. There is no need for you to calculate, but you should know a logic. When you are telling, sir, sharpen ratio to ye hai aur wo ye hai, and then see if I will calculate, how I have to calculate the sharp ratio. Return minus standard deviation divided by risk-free rate of return. Okay, this I will divide. When I will calculate, I will come to know my sharpen ratio of B mutual fund is 1. And my sharpen ratio of A mutual fund is 0.9. It means what actually? Even though mutual fund A has a higher return, if you will see, mutual fund A return is 12%. Mutual fund B has a higher risk adjusted return. Because my risk was 1 unit only, but out of that 1 unit of risk, my return is more over here in B mutual fund. So what should I tell them? Because see, return is not the one way. Risk is also there with the kind of return that they are generating. So my advice to my person who is coming to me and meeting me, ma'am, which mutual fund should I buy? My advice should be B mutual fund, not A mutual fund. Okay, this is one of the, and then we'll see the T ratios.